така аудитория. Тя подобява рич джином, правим в момента с байдите с метатори. Позвольте ни поговорить дальше по-английски. When I switched to bioinformatics, it was 2001, I was just a visiting scientist at the university in Umea, at North Sweden, at the Department of Biophysical Chemistry. I received a call from Leipzig University and they offered me a position as managing director of the newly formed Center for Bioinformatics at Leipzig University. I applied for this job in spring. I even forgot about this, but then I received this call and I returned to Leipzig, but I will come to this back to this point later. A few words about my prehistory. I studied at Kharkov State University. You see it here. You see at those time it looked many things a bit different. For young people, this is Karl Marx, this is Friedrich Engels, and this is Vladimir Ilyich. And here is written, Udarnum zu Burgen, I Adlichne, und Schaubrief, Strechen, Trotz, Gratis, Jest, KPSS. Вот такие времена. Но я, I did my diploma in biophysics at Kharkov University, about the topic, a mathematical model of the aggregation of thrombocytes that's really actual even in medical bioinformatics today. What is important, Lev Landau, Soviet Einstein, was professor for 6 years in Kharkov in the 30s. He was born in Baku, not so far from here, and he got the Nobel Prize 1962 about theory of condensed matter. And I, by the way, I heard Mathematical Analysis, one of his scholars gave the lectures in Mathematical, of Landau gave the lectures about analysis. Landau was also in Leipzig, 1929. It was in this old physical institute. It was destroyed during the war. It now looks like this. And he visited Werner Heisenberg. I saw the, his counterfeit there on this floor. Werner Heisenberg was from 27 to 22 in Leipzig, and he received Nobel Prize in Physics for a foundation of quantum mechanics. And this is the Heisenberg's uncertainty relation. Yeah? So. Another important thing from Leipzig is the integral sign. It was designed by Leibniz. He was born in Leipzig, and he is the founder of the differential and integral calculus in mathematics. So here is the original manuscript, here is the sign. So, and this is the old main building of the Leipzig University. It was partly destroyed, completely destroyed during socialist time, and so it looks now. I returned from Kharkov to Leipzig and did my PhD, Doctor Rerum Naturalium, in Latin, about computer experiments on two-dimensional systems, a model for phospholipid membranes. Later, I did my habilitation there, also at the Physics Institute. This is, by the way, the Christmas lecture, the famous Christmas lecture at Physics Institute in Leipzig. See a lot of fire, a lot of girls, a lot of listeners from all over Leipzig. So I did my habilitation about infrared dichroism of molecular order systems, a study on hydration and structure of DNA lipids. So this was work in experimental physics, and this was the work in theoretical physics. But all my life, I worked with computers. During my diploma work, I used this Soviet machine, Mir 2. It has a light pencil. Probably its power was like my hours here, watches. Later I worked, later I worked with this kind of computer. 6 tons, occupied place like this room, and power like much less than the smartphone, I would say. And so on and so on. Later there are other computers, the first DOS PCs, then the Windows 1 to Windows 10 I used. So if you put the power of computers in terms of the number of transistors per chip, in the logarithmic scale over the years you obtain a linear dependency, what is called Moore's law, which simply tells that every 2 years the power of computers doubles. Until now, even, by the way. But coming back, we will need this later. Coming back to 2001. I left Umea, and Umea is now important for this woman, Emmanuelle Carpentier. She was there later, from 2009 to 2013, where she did the essential work for her Nobel Prize in Chemistry last year about the gene system. So, remind, everywhere where I visited the university, there either were Nobel Prize winners or they became. So it's a good decision to give me my job to doctor. Exactly in the in 2001, at the same year, the sequence of human genome was obtained in a long process of 10 years of hundreds of scientists, and it was very expensive, $3 billion. And it was published just in 2001. It has also relations to the formation of the Interdisciplinary Center of Bioinformatics in Leipzig. But the general hope was, if you know the building plan of life, it will help you to make life better, fight against diseases, curing diseases, etc. This was the hope. And only to give you an expression of what the human genome means, it contains of 3 billion letters. If you write them on paper, it will result in 2,500 books. There are 500 pages, it will become a heap of 100 meters approximately, so one sort of the Eiffel Tower in Paris. So it's a huge amount of information, and this information looks like that. So can you see the miracles of life reading these letters? Probably not. Nobody can do this. So the problem is reading, interpreting, and translation into practice. This is the problem. And for this, we need bioinformatics. And because just in the 90s, people come to the result that this bioinformatics is needed, they decided to found a bioinformatics center at Leipzig University, not only by the way. So the DNA code, so these letters are individual for each person, change with age between cells, transform into a vast universum of molecules and mechanisms. So it needs not also bioinformatics, what it consists of biology and data science. It's a combination of both. Otherwise you would not understand what is happening. So it's like the different hieroglyphs. You see here it's symbols, but you have to know transcription. Here's the oil sitting over here. It's some similarity, but it needs a translation. Yeah, and this is also needed for the human genome. But coming back to the computer development of computers. So it started here at 2001, and this is Moore's law. I showed you doubling of transistors or number of transistors every 2 years. It's the white curve. The green curve is the development of sequencing technologies. So it follows Moore's law until 2007, but later its development was much, much faster, as you can see here. So it's the price, so it's the inverse of the dependency I showed before. So it goes down very quickly, and now it levels off by around $1,000 per genome. But the genome, I told you, is complicated. The DNA has can have a lot of modifications that affect transcription or its function. It is wrapped around such spheres called nucleosomes that it formed, is packed in the chromatin and such structures to fit into the nucleus. It is transcribed, then it's translated, so it induced a complex machinery, ended up in a complex network of thousands of components, and finally, this is the miracle of life. And this we should discover. One application is artifacts in the genome leading to cancer. And going again through the time from the 90s until now, there are a lot of discoveries. This is Genome Project, simply to understand how the genome works. Around 2010, ENCODE, this was a Nature publication about, or a series of Nature publications about the role of transcripts that is produced by the genome. Now we have single cell sequencing, so we can go into the cells, and for single cells can extract the genome and say what each single cell does exactly, and what is the difference between this cell and another cell. And also, there was last year a series of papers in Nature about the cancer. So we now know a lot, much more about cancer than, say, 20 years ago. And also Nobel Prizes, we have 3 years ago, two Nobel Prize winners for the immune therapy against cancer, which is very important thing to fight against this disease. And as I told before, in 2020, these two women received the Nobel Prize for the gene scissor. A very actual application of genome biology are the vaccinations against COVID. It was only possible because the genome of the virus was decoded, and using this new mRNA technology, one could design vaccines against this disease. There are two companies, BioNTech in Germany and Pfizer in the US, and Moderna in the US, and the impact is shown in this. Stock values, they gained by 2,000% in the last 2 years. So, what is bioinformatics? Let's summarize what are the ingredients. At one hand side, you have to know life science concepts and models, systems biology, molecular biology, evolution, translational medicine, personalized medicine, etc. You have a lot of data to analyze, genomic data, epigenomic data, metabolomic data, and if necessary, also clinical and phenotype data. You have a data side of the problem. And you have to work with computers, you have computational and analytic approaches, yeah? Including experimental sequencing technologies. So all three areas have to be put together for in the area of bioinformatics. I showed you that the price for sequencing steeply goes down from $3 billion to $1,000. Human genome, but the problem is now that the analysis is much more expensive. So the limiting factor is not the sequencing alone, the limiting factor are the people, the experts that can analyze the genome. So, and this is exactly the problem, and that's why in the 90s the European Bioinformatics Institute was founded, 10 years later in Leipzig. And now bioinformatics departments became common or standard in nearly all German universities. This was the situation in 2002, five centers were founded, established in Germany. This is the situation now, you have centers everywhere. These are centers or chairs for bioinformatics at the universities. So it's a normal field of science and education at nearly all basic universities in Leipzig. So, what is the situation in Armenia? This is Itzbi, and 10 years later, Osin, by certain reasons, founded this big group at the Institute of Molecular Biology as a first step to establish bioinformatics as a science in Armenia. We started our cooperation in 2013, and 2015 we won a large grant. Here is the original, the copy paste version of the scheme that described our goals at those times. So Leipzig ITSBI cooperates with Yerevan Institute for Molecular Biology, and here RRU. I was not so common with the ordering of letters. Rau.
Yes.
So Rau is from the beginning in our attention. So these are different areas of work, but what is most important, our vision at those times was foundation or something like this of an Armenian genome center. We still don't have this, but we have something going in the right direction, I would say. But let me first summarize a few results of our cooperation. We started first publication or joint publication came out 2014 with a lot of Russian colleagues and about cosmonauts. And this is one of our last results of cooperation booklet from this year. Overall, we have together 21 publications. What is quite a lot in this relatively short time. In addition, we had four German academic exchange service visits from Maria, by the way, also in Leipzig. We had two projects, big projects from German side, two projects from Armenian side, three co-supervised PhDs, more than 400,000 Euro money to treat, annual work stays between 2 and 6 months, nearly every year, in both directions. Two workshops, the last one was before COVID in summer 2019, Genome Bioinformatics for Health, the first bioinformatics workshop or conference in Yerevan. And I don't know, you can see this. This is a Kashtan, I don't know how in English. So I've planted it 2014 as Osen was in Leipzig for his first stay, and it was of this high. So now you see how it grew. So in our cooperation also grew in a similar way. These are the new plants. Siras, Maria, Roxana, Lilith. These are my people, Henry, Edith, Lydia, and Maria. And it grows as a seed, and this is third generation, not sequencing, as you like to say, third generation bioinformaticians that appeared this year, and I'm very happy to see them, to meet them during my stay here. And so I'm very hopeful what concerns further development of bioinformatics in Armenia. Okay, a few examples of our work. One is interesting thing is about divine dissemination across the world. We used genomic data, and what comes out? Every dot here is in wine, pretty more. Here it goes in several directions. This is Western Europe, this is Spain, this is Middle East, this is Balkan and Italy, and at the crossroad of everything are the Armenian assessing, but for fairness I have to say other Georgians are here, so it's presently not clear, but both are at this crossroad, and this suggests that the origin of winemaking is anywhere here in the South Caucasus. Another work, by the way, this first author is Maria, your student, also here, first author is Maria, about population level assessment of the distribution of disease-associated variants, with focus on Armenians. So we studied the distribution of people around the world. This is Armenians, and we could figure out a few diseases that are, how to say, of high incidence or probability using this genomic data. Oh, sorry, another result was from this year about corona, where we analyzed corona variants across the globe, and also the data that were generated here in Roxana's lab with nanopore sequencing. And so we put the Armenian samples into the context of the data that we collected, that we downloaded from all over the world. So I didn't yet answer why bioinformatics is mandatory. So this is still the question. I told you there are a lot of interesting, complicated things. Let's give an answer. It's mandatory by the same reason why integral in mathematics or in science in general, and the uncertainty relation in physics also are both mandatory for science in general. So the answer is the same for bioinformatics. It's cross-sectional science linking all areas of biology, and it's also interesting for data science. Build university around science. I have stolen this phrase by your rental. I like this very much because this is the right way. This is the right way and not vice versa. These are the rankings. I only want to mention first place Lomonosov State University is clear, but what was for me interesting, University of Tartu, Estonia, 1 million or 1 and 200,000 million people live in Estonia. Small country, at second place. And Lomonosov has 100 points, Tartu 95, so it's approximately the same level. Kharkov University is here, 67, 50 points, so half as good. I don't like so much these rankings, but anyway, it's interesting. Russian University, 131, 30 points. So one third of the level of Lomonosov. Garbutt's also not so bad, but there is still resources on top. Yeah, and Yerevan State, they are still sleeping in Soviet time, is my impression. So, sorry for this. Okay, Burg University around science. And science around centers. It's also important. For two weeks ago, I found this Nature Genetics paper. It's interesting about genomics of the blood and EQTL relation to phenotypes. And the first author looked strange. Omo Vösa is from Estonian genome center. Yeah? And also Leipzig University contributed. So if you have good data, you will be invited to such joint projects, and you will have good results. And coming back to Armenia and centers, we have the Institute of Molecular Biology, we have the RAU, we have the new Armenian Bioinformatics Institute, and hopefully in next future, the Armenian Genome Project. And this will give the same drive for Armenia, hopefully, as the drive of the Tartu University obtained from the Estonian Genome Center. Okay, who should build genome bioinformatics in Armenia? Diaspora people, the foreigners, like me for example, or Armenian Armenians? I, by the way, read an interesting, very interesting paper in, it's Yerevan, EVN reports, the use of national science. I recommend to read this. It's very, very honest opinion about the science. My answer is the best, independent where they are coming from. There's only one science in the world, and brain and heart count. Yeah? And to whom belongs Einstein? I don't know. It's German, Jew, American. It's human. Yeah? Scientist. So, that's my statement. Presently, Armenians are the drivers of science and in genome bioinformatics in Armenia. Very clear statement from my side. Supported, of course, by international corporations I told about us, and of course, diaspora. So, be proud of your scientists. Okay, coming near to the end, one more thing at the end. Keep the Cartesian index low. You think this is a joke? No.
Okay.
You know what is the Cartesian index?
No.
First, I have to say it's not a joke, it's a paper in genome biology, is a high impact paper in genome biology. Yeah? 14 or nearly 14 impact points. The Cartesian index is the ratio between the followers on Twitter or Facebook divided by the number of citations. And if it is low, you have either a lot of citations but a low number of followers, and if it's high, then you have a lot of followers but a low number of citations. The normal situation is anywhere here along this line, and this, where the Cartesian index is high, are the science conditions. Yeah. Now let's look. It's a very wise article. Who are the science conditions, or what we learn from this? I will cite from this article. A high Cartesian index is a warning to the community that the researcher X may have built its public profile on shaky foundations. Number one. Number two, social media makes it very easy for people to build a seemingly impressive persona by essentially shooting louder than others. Think about maybe you find persons in Armenia that fit to this description. Third, I propose that all scientists calculate their own K index, Cartesian index, on an annual basis and include it in their Twitter profile. Not only does this help others decide how much weight they should give to the someone's 140 characters, that's the Twitter name, character wisdom, it can also be an incentive. If your K index gets about 5, that's the limiting the threshold, then it's time to get off Twitter and write papers. And finally, most Cartesians are men. It's also interesting. they calculated statistics, the relation of men and women in high Cartesians and most Cartesians are men. So, follow me on Twitter if you have a question to increase my Cartesian index. Schmarr hat es gerade tun. Das ist super.